Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yabra. You may be seated, YisraYah. I always delight when it's time, as David said, when it's time to enter into the presence of Almighty Yah. What a great delight it is that we gather in Yahshua's mighty name to hear what Yah speaks unto his people, that we may, by the trying of this truth, that we all might be refined, that we may walk with great delight in the abundance of the riches of Yah's Iman. We're living in a time, YisraYah, whereby we as a nation, a people, we must consistently hear the mind of Yah speaks unto YisraYah. We must hear what his mind speaks. We cannot rely upon the mind of man, but we must hear what the mind of Almighty Yah speaks unto YisraYah. And if the mind or the words that are spoken unto us, if it's not of the representation of the mind of Yah, there is deceit and every kind of evil and corrupt workings in that mind. We must hear what the mind of Yah speaks unto YisraYah. And this day I shall speak by the mind of Almighty Yah. This is a generation that cannot hear the mind of Yah speak. Yahshua said to those that were prominent and those that had position of authority and power to deduct, to create delusions out of the Torah, he said that you are a generation of vipers. And that's this generation. It is a generation of vipers. He said, you, a generation of vipers, how can you that are very evil speak that which is Tav, or the excellence of Almighty Yah? How can you speak unto us the excellent things of Yah when you are a corrupt, vile generation of people? He says, it is a certain that out of the Tav heart, or the Tav treasures of the heart, the Lev, does a man speak, and out of the evil treasures of the Lev, an evil man, or the evil deeds are purported, they are practiced, and they are spoken. We are a generation of vipers. We don't know how to hear what is Tav and what is right from Almighty Yah. His Tav is his excellence. The excellence of his might, his power, it is what comes from his bosom. For we know that out of the abundance of the Lev, even as Yahshua expressed, for out of the abundance of the Lev does the heart speak. And the heart speaks from its abundance. It speaks from its abundance. And Yah speaks unto YisraYah out of the abundance of his Lev. When the rich young ruler tried Yahshua, when he asked him, what must I do to enter into the kingdom? And he gave him the commands of Almighty Yah, what the Torah said. He says unto him, you are a Tav master. Tav master. And Yahshua, understanding that this man did not even know the implications of his speech, and so he says unto him, he said, there is none that is Tav, only Yah who is Tav. So what he was implying, if I am the Tav of Yah, then you must identify that I have come from the Most High. You know that there is no one that is Tav but Yah. He is the most excellent one. He is the one of excellency. He is the one of power and might. And you are calling me Tav? We know that every Tav and perfect gift comes from Yah. And the only way we can understand that, we must understand the mind. And the mind of Yah in this generation must speak unto YisraYah. And the first action of the mind of Yah, it is the action of Mishpatim. He brings judgment to set the house of YisraYah right. So on the day of atonement, we can come before him with gladness of our levim, of our bosom. He must set the heart of YHWH right. I speak to us today, the mind of YAH. And I speak from the mind of YAH, not just his mind, but I speak by the mind of Almighty YAH. I want to take my time today. That's why I requested one song, and then let me preach, teach, whatever it takes to bring the resolution of our bosom that we will love him with all of our heart, all of our nefesh, all of our leba, and all of our strength. We must comply to what YAH has commanded us to do. He has not given us any order that is taxing upon us. We tax ourselves with sin and every kind of wickedness that proceeds from our hearts. Our actions are what proceeds from our bosom. For out of the lab proceeds adultery, fornication, every kind of wickedness that is imaginable in the mind of man. That's why we must hear the mind of Almighty YAH speaking to us. Our minds constantly speak to us. And it causes us to do wrong, to operate in wickedness. We do things to defy YAH. We have no conscience of that. We must hear the mind of YAH. And if a man speaks not according to the mind of YAH, the discipline of Torah, the strength of Torah, the wisdom of Torah, the knowledge of Torah, the understanding of Torah, he is not speaking the mind of Almighty YAH. He is speaking from a convoluted perception that is based upon his own interpretation. He has not mastered or matured in the knowledge of YAH, and so his words are not of substance and strength at all. He is one as that just simply repeats the same matters over and over. That's why the young ruler asked YHWH, "What must I do?" He spoke, and he is the mind of Almighty YAH. I want to begin here on this course today in the Katve, out of the book of Romans, chapter 11 and verse 13. Here Shaul writes unto the scattered house of YHWH, as he speaks of the adoring or his adoration for the wisdom of Almighty YAH and YAH's justice. He is just in all of his ways. And he speaks unto us in this phrase or phraseology that we may understand, first of all the depths. He talks about the depth and the riches of both the wisdom, the chokhmah, the experience with YAH, Romans 11:33. He speaks of the depths of the wisdom, our experience, as we continuously to traverse throughout the Torah of YAH and finding the delights of the riches or the depths of Torah that inspires us to go beyond the place that we are and begin to move into the excellence of YAH's power, that we truly have the power to lay hands. We truly have the strength to trust YAH, even in death, and even against the perils of opposition from the enemy of YAH, has Shaltan. He says, all the depth of the riches, the esha, the happiness, the splendid, both of the wisdom, the chokhmah, and the da'at, the knowledge of Almighty YAH. He said, it is of such great enrichment, the depths, the breath, the understanding of what the mind of YAH speaks. His wisdom speaks his mind. His understanding speaks his mind. His knowledge speaks his mind. His fear speaks his mind. His judgment, it proceeds out of the one, only one that is Tav and that is Yah. Out of the tov treasures of a tov heart, the abundance of the faith, the mouth speaks. So Yah speaks to YHWH. I want to temper this because we must understand we're not hearing from the mind of Yah. We're hearing from this created mind that has been created by the mandate of every kind of wickedness, every kind of sin. That's why our imaginations and our thoughts are constantly on things that are vile, wicked, and evil. We don't think of the tough things of Yah. Our minds are not indicted when we hear the Torah of Yah. So the depths, the greatness of the riches, the Yeshua that brings the shalom and the happiness of Yah, he says unto us, how unsearchable are his judgments. You cannot search out the finite details of the beauty of the judgments of Almighty Yah. And we as a nation, we're always offended at the mishpatim. And it is his love kindness. It is way of correcting us, to bring us closer to him, to warn us against those things that will bring death. And there is no forgiveness for that at all. I speak to YHWH by the mind of Almighty Yah. And his ways or his derech, they are past finding out. You can't find out the beauty of Yah through your intellectual pursuit. It must come by the Ruach HaKodesh, not the damned, wicked, Holy Ghost, not the damnable, wicked, Holy Spirit, but by the Ruach. And Yah is a Ruach. But by the Ruach HaKodesh, the only spirit that is set apart from the devious workings of hell. That is the only way. So these things are past finding out. How do we find them out? Has he hidden them from us not to know? He has not. Yahweh says in verse 34, for who has yada, has experience, who knows, who has been fashioned, who knows the lebat, the mind of Yah, or who has been the counselor or the advisor of Almighty Yah? Who has known the mind of Yah? Has he given us his mind? Well, certainly, he has given us his mind. For the power of his mind is the revelation of Torah. And if the Torah does not substantiate that, then we don't know the mind of Yah. Then we can pursue our own endeavors. We can go toward the things that are pleasing unto us. And so what this book says, it has no value at all. For who has known the mind of Yah? For who has spoken to counsel him? When Yah says to Moshe, I will destroy them all, Yah says, Moshe say, blot out my name. This man had the mind of Yah that he could counsel or speak unto Yah. And because Yah had this great affinity, this affection for Moshe, he said, I will spare the house because of you. We must understand his mind. We must let that mind develop in us. It must be the mind of Torah, the delight of Torah, the excitement, the riches, and the depths of Torah. Not a folly and trivial pursuits that leads to nothing, that damns us and separates us from Yah, and cause us to pursue every kind of vile, wicked activity. We become practitioners of things that are diametrically opposed unto Yah, Because we began to operate in this sensual, carnal, wicked mind that gravitates to everything that is lustful and wicked, because that is the motive of one's heart, the desire. It has come from within, and we will pursue that. And if the Yahav of Yah is not in us, we will not pursue the mind of Yah. It is the great mind of great depth and great riches. There are men that sit under their teachers for years just to comprehend the smallest of details of life or the order and pattern of thing that that individual is pursuing. Are we pursuing eternal life? Is the affection of YHWH set on things that are above, that we should sit at the Master's feet to understand and to learn exactly what it takes? What must I endure for this endeavor that my love delights in? That I want the fullness of this depth of riches and knowledge. I want the mind of Yah to guide me in the very precise details of his mandate and what he commands me to do. Who has known the mind of Yah? Who has understood the great riches of Almighty Yah? I speak the mind of Yah to YHWH on this Shabbat Shabbaton. I speak that mind and no other mind. Damn every mind that opposes the instruction, the muzah, the discipline, the chastisement, the correction that Yah's mind speaks unto YHWH. I direct your attention to the writings of Shaul here in 1 Corinthians. I want to read this carefully, and I want you to follow along with me. It says here in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, I want to begin reading at verse 6. As Shaul speaks unto the scattered house, he is trying to express unto them the profoundness of the power of the doctrine of Yah, or wisdom whereby contains the doctrine of Yah. It is by the wisdom of Yah that we understand the doctrine. What is doctrine? The discipline of Almighty Yah. How we must walk, how we must carry ourselves in the sight of Yah, how we bring the offering, how we present our bodies unto him as a living offering unto him. And so Shaul speaks of the excellence, the richness, the depths of this profound wisdom that caused the discipline of Yah's doctrine to formulate in our minds, and we pursue it with great delight. And so he uttered with deep conviction unto the gathering, unto the Israelites there in Corinth. He says, yet, verse 6, 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 6. He said, yet we speak wisdom among them that are perfect, those that are tomim, those that have matured in the knowledge of Yah, those that have the rite of passage, those that delight in understanding and wisdom. So the wisdom of Yah, or the mind of Yah, is spoken unto them that are perfect, those that are mature, that are able to bear strong meats, that are able to eat the meat of Yah. He said, yet not the wisdom of this world. We don't speak this wisdom that is based upon principles that are carnal, earthly, and sensual. He said, this is not the wisdom we speak, and that's what our minds constantly inundate us with, speaks to us, commands us of the wisdom of the world, the folly, the trivial wisdom of the world that produces nothing but death and corruption. Every kind of evil works comes from the wisdom of the world. It is opposite of Yah's wisdom, YHWH. The mind of the world is not like the mind of Yah. It is opposed. The mind of the world hates Yah. The mind of this viper generation, it despises Yah. That's why it speaks evil of Yah. That's why it is no concept in that mind of the beauty of the concepts of Yah's wisdom that formulates doctrine. It gives us strength. It gives us power to pursue the kingdom values of Almighty Yah. We will be strong with the resolution of the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. And not the testimony or the aspiration of the world, and everything we speak is about the world, what we desire in this realm of life. Something is drastically wrong in our minds. The mind of Yah is not speaking unto us. We don't speak according to the wisdom of this world or the rulers of this world, because all that comes to nothing. The wisdom of this world, the rulers, the princes, the powers, the things that dominate our lives, it all comes to nothing. What rules in our minds, what rules in our spirits, it does not project any kind of image of anything of strength at all. It shows us the frailty and the weakness of our own nature. The mind of Yah spoke and it was. And when that mind speaks to us, it creates the power of his image in us. That's why we don't give a damn. And we don't want to hear from Yah. We don't want to hear his mind. What I left out here Thursday, I tend to scan a radio station. And by chance that day, I scanned and there was PBS. And they were talking about this law that is being passed in California. It's on the Honorable Governor Brown's desk to sign into law. That school system must teach the beauty, the advancements that has been caused, the great enrichment and the great rewards that these damnable faggot sodomite dogs have enriched this wicked, vile nation. They're teaching your sons and daughters to be a faggot sodomite dog, saying that they have been a tremendous inspiration to this nation. And yet the people of the diasporas who built this damn wicked nation from its foundations, many of the schools are eradicating anything about slavery. They don't want to touch on those things, but yet they want to grandize a damn freak, a damn sodomite dog. This is not the mind of Yah. This is not the Ruach of Yah. You don't give your children over unto that kind of covenant of the wicked. And because we will not receive the mind of Yah and hear what the mind of Yah speaks, then we are taken advantage of. That's the wisdom of this world. To say that a damn faggot dog, that's a sodomite. A pedophilia that desire your young boys and your young daughters, this is all right. An individual that is so damn twisted they don't even know whether one is a man or one is a woman, that is a damnable, twisted, satanic, sick, depraved, wicked mind. I don't give a damn what anyone says. They can put me in jail. I will not stop preaching like this. I will not uphold this wickedness. I laid that out because I'm going to show us a wickedness that is beyond our comprehension. And then there is no forgiveness for that wickedness. I speak the mind of Yah to YisraYah this day. Yahweh says in verse 7, but we, Zabah, we speak the wisdom of Yah. He says we speak it in a lach, in secrecy. It is not intended for the wicked to know. It is not intended for the vile, impugnant, desirous of every kind of vile thing to know. It's intended for you to know the secrecy of Yah. And so he speaks his mind in his assembly in the quiet place among Yisra'iyah. And he opens up the door, and that door, the first thing that penetrates our minds is the testimony of Yahshua. Without that power, you don't have a damn thing, Yisra'iyah. We're going to part away and waste away and die just like the wicked man. He says, I speak this in Lance. He said, even the pala, the hidden things. He is talking about those things that are so marvelous and so wonderful that it is not a part of the landscape of a natural mind. It has to be revealed by the mind of Almighty Yah. It cannot be revealed any other way. It has to be revealed by Yah's mind. We cannot understand the power of Torah unless the mind of Yah speaks it and reveals it unto us. We cannot understand that. He said, which Yah ordained before the world to our honor, our kabod. Yah has ordained this wisdom before the beginning of the world. To what? To honor us, Yisra'iyah. To show the excellence of our power, our might, our strength, our beauty, and to show the excellence of his wisdom that abides in us. But because we are so secular and so carnal, we love to have this sensualizing of our flesh and to enjoy everything that pertains to flesh and the wisdom of Yah, the doctrines of Yah. We don't care about those things. We don't want those things. That is the thing that make us a peculiar people set above every nation, that we delight in the doctrines of Almighty Yahweh. And if we don't delight in that, we have reduced ourselves just like the goyim, the wicked nations that defy the principles of Yah. And in our own activities and actions, each day we do that. We defy his principles. We reject his mind. We don't receive the riches of his mind. The riches of his mind spoken, look what we see. That's a rich mind. That's a powerful mind. The riches of his mind spoke and said, it repented me that I made man. Because every thought and every imagination of his love is evil wickedness only continuously. Examine our own love and see what is only continuously in our minds. Is it the concept of Yah's truth? Do we delight to obey the doctrines of the principles of Yah? We don't do that wholeheartedly, Yisra'iyah. He said, which none of the rulers of this world knew, which none of the powers of darkness, which none of the princes, none of the shadim, the demons or the forces of hell that Yah created, not none of them knew, for if had they known it, they would have not impelled the master of Chabot. If the demons of darkness had known the power in that mind of Yahshua, that body, they would have never impelled him. They did not understand the power of that death. They did not understand what it would release unto Yisra'iyah. They didn't understand the honor that it would bring unto a people Yah had elected. They did not understand that because if they had known, they would have never impelled him. And because they don't know, they don't understand the power of the mind of Yah, the riches of Yah that he has placed in Yisra'iyah. And that's why they're constantly pursuing to destroy the mind, the wisdom of Yah out of our bosom. And of course, we grant the wicked one the occasion to do that because we're so easily deceived. We're so easily taken aback, awash. And then we remove ourselves from truth. Hallelujah. He to this day doesn't know. To this day he cannot discern. They did not discern even in Yahshua. For if they had known, they would have never impelled him. Because the door that impelling opened, it opened all things pertaining to the character of Yah, his characteristic. It opened that for Yisra'iyah. And we as a rebellious, stiff-necked people, we just don't give a damn. And we rebel persistently, constantly against Yah. We don't even fight against ourselves, the wickedness, the deplorable things that our own wickedness do to us. But yet when it comes to Yah, we will resist, we will fight, we will oppose constantly all day in our sleep. In every activity of our actions, we oppose Almighty Yah. And it's wrong, YHWH. It's wrong. Verse 9. But as it is hatab, as it is written in the Shefa, in the love of your eyes, the eye has not seen, nor the ears in the ear heard, neither have entered into the love of man the things which Yah has prepared for them that love him. Listen to me, Yisrael. I want you to shemach. I know what these wicked men use that for today. That the things that Yah has prepared for us, pertaining to natural things or the things of the kingdom. Listen, you cannot understand the beauty of the melchut of Yah, the kingdom, unless you have the mind of Yah. He has prepared in his wisdom the power to live lives that are so profound, that are so upstanding and outstanding, that the world marvels at us. He has prepared for us a wisdom of understanding of such great power that when our mouths open, it speaks the mind of Yah. He has given unto us the power of such great judgment, like he did with Shlomo in his first action, that the world will come and pursue us to judge the matter, to give us insight. These are the things he has prepared. Hell, a house doesn't mean a thing. A mansion without the wisdom of Yah, it doesn't mean a damn thing, Yisrael. But this is what he has prepared in that body that was prepared to take away our sins and to destroy the works of hell. He prepared that in that body. He prepared his wisdom, his mind in that body. He prepared his fear, his counsel in that body. He prepared the power of his identity, his Ruach HaKodesh in that body. He has prepared great things for his house. And the depths of that wisdom of Yah, it is beyond our comprehension. Because the mind of Yah has not been spoken to the house of Yisrael this day. He says in verse 10, listen to this. But Yah has revealed them or made known the revelation of them to us by his Ruach. For the Ruach, the Spirit, Yah, he searches all things. Yes, the Ruach of Yah searches the deep things. Shaul writes, as I wrote at first, all the depths and also the riches of both the wisdom and da'at, the knowledge of Almighty Yah. And yet the Ruach of Yah, it endeavors, it digs down into the riches of Yah's wisdom. That's why this phony, damnable thing called the Holy Ghost has been poured out upon the masses of the people. It doesn't search the depths. When a man has the Ruach, truly, the Ruach HaKodesh of Yah, when a daughter, a bath of Tizayon has that Ruach, she searches the depths. Her mind is driven to the depths, not to the depths of every kind of dam in your window. Every kind of spirit of gossip and hearsay, it doesn't search that out. We will search out those damn wicked things. But we will not search out the riches and the depths of Yah. He said it is the Ruach of Yah that searches out the depths, out the unsearchable riches of Yah. And the Ruach HaKodesh, it is the promise of Yah unto Yisrael. Why are we not operating in that power? Well, we're not searching out the depths of his riches. We can hear an innuendo or a hearsay or a heresy against Yah or against his people. We will search out the damnable, deplorable thing. Yes. Spend energy and time trying to find out who said what. Yes. And yet when the Ruach speaks to us by the messenger of Yah, we don't search out the riches of those things that are conveyed unto us by the mind of Almighty Yah. I have the mind of Yah because I have the power of YHWH's testimony in my vessel. I speak by the mind of Almighty Yah. I speak only by that mind. damn the mind of David. I speak by the mind of Almighty Yah. For that mystery of the power of Yahshua is revealed unto the true messengers of Almighty Yah. Not these pseudos, false liars of deception, these damnable Jesus thumpers and liars. I know what I'm saying. I will show you as I proceed. I want you to bind up your flesh to hear today. And with you that are listening, quit your running around in your homes, eating and nibbling, and eat this lechem of Almighty Yah. Hear this again, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says again in verse 10, but Yah has revealed them to us by his ruach, by his mind. For the ruach searches not some of the things, not a partial listing, but call all things, yes, the deep things. Emphatically, the ruach only searches the deep things of Yah. So this damn thing called the Holy Ghost is searches for the gratification of one's damnable twisted flesh. That's all it searches for. But the Ruach HaKodesh, the Ruach, the Spirit of Yah, it searches the deep things of the Torah. It searches the deep things of the testimony of Yahshua. It searches the riches of the power of Yah's mind. It digs into the depths of Yah's mind continuously. We are constantly thrust into the presence of Yah to bring an offering according to the acceptance of his mind. According to his acceptance, not ours. But what is acceptable before him, the Ruach searches the deep things. At any time, our minds are not searching the depths of Torah, the wisdom, the hukmah of Yah, the da'at, the understanding, the divinah, the discernment, then something is wrong. We don't have the Ruach of Yah. We have the same spirit of the world. We have the same spirit of the world. It is the Ruach that searches the deep things of Almighty Yah, and that's why this pseudo-type spirit that has overtaken the world and this religious whore called Christianity that pours out this damn vile thing that they call the Holy Ghost, that spirit doesn't make them search the deep things of the riches of Yah. It makes them gravitate and search for the things that satisfy the flesh. And they're always talking about the riches of their blessings. And they don't have the berakhah, the blessings, the riches of Yah. The ruach searches the deep things, the secrets, the lath of Yah. Those things that are reserved, preserved only in the testimony of Yahshua, they're hidden. And only when that testimony is revealed, it's alive in us. It is what rejuvenates us. It is what rejuvenates us. It is what causes us to live. It is what caused us to rejoice. It is what caused us to dance. It is what caused us to shout. Only then shall the secret of the mystery of the things of Yah from the beginning will be revealed unto us. And then that sets in motion that mind of Yah to seek out and search out the riches of the depth of his Torah he has written in the Lev of Yisrael. And that is the truth, Yisrael. Hallelujah. 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 He says in verse 11, for who yada the things of a man? Who knows the things of a man? Except it be the ruach of the spirit of man which is in him. I understand the nature of man because I have the spirit of man in me. I understand my frail nature, my juvenileness, my immaturity, my likes and my dislikes, the wisdom of how many states in the United States, and those kinds of things. How does a man know that? But it's by the spirit of man. Why? Because these things have been ordained by man. To understand the beauty of a pine tree, I don't understand that. But Yah says, let that be the cedar of Lebanon. And out of that, as the birds took seeds of Lebanon and dropped them in this climate, it produced a pine, it produced a redwood pine, and they all came out of the cedar of Lebanon. So I don't understand that. But the things of man I understand, because the spirit of man that has been birthed in me by man has been taught by man. I understand those things. He goes on to say, even so the things of Yah, Yada, no man, is not innate in him to understand those things. He said, but the Ruach of Yah, the spirit of Yah, for Yah is the only powerful Ruach. And you cannot understand the things of Yah unless the testimony of his life is in you. And that testimony is Yahshua HaMashiach. You can read the Torah all you want to, but if there's no power of Yahshua HaMashiach, there is no power in you at all. You can dissect, you can speak Hebrew, you can interpret it as according to the young, rich lawyer when he approached Yahshua, but there is no power of life in the man. He knew that he was a tough man, Yahshua. He knew that the Torah taught that there was only one Tav. And Yahshua said, if you call me Tav, then you know I am the testimony, the power. I am the Torah of Almighty God, that the Nabi wrote of, that I should come, and I am, and you are in my presence. That lawyer represents the very mind of Yisrael. Our minds are always fighting and trying to contradict Torah. We are trying to establish our own credence in Torah, but you're going to be brought down to the side of hell, my friend. You're going to be brought down to the gate of hell. For your damn mind shall be brought to nothing. It shall go back to the dust. It shall not establish the Sadiq of Yah. The Sadiq of Yah is established by his mind. That there will be no doubt. It is consistent throughout every people, every nation. It is right. I'm driving to a point that I want us to understand. I know that I want to regress to last week's message, but when Yah began to pound in my life, and in the late hours of the night when I sit there in the early hours of the morning, I must go in the direction. You must take what you hear and pursue that and understand the ingredients of that. And your lamb must be set upon that to shape the mind of Yah according to his purpose and his will. You cannot allow the mind of man to constantly inundate, to alter and to change what Yah speaks unto you. We must do that, Yisrael. So I cannot regress. We must press on. We're coming to the end of all things. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says, now we receive not the Ruach or the spirit of this Ulam, the world. He said, but we have received the Ruach which is of Yah. You have not received the damn Holy Ghost. We have received the Ruach, the spirit which is of Yah. You know that it is the Ruach of Yah because it is constantly counseling us and judging us, correcting us. The spirit of the world or the Holy Ghost never indicts. It is the Ruach. I don't give a damn if you don't like it. It never indicts. And that's why we got to rid ourselves of these damn pagan institutions that have been formulated and formed in our minds after the traditions of man. The Holy Ghost is after the tradition of man. But the Ruach HaKodesh is after Yah's created power of his mind. And that's what the Ruach does. It creates the image and the power of Yahshua in us. What is our image? What is the imagery of your mind constantly? It is the beauty of Yah. It is the beauty of the kingdom. Or is it our own selfish, wicked, grandizing pursuits of wickedness? Now talk to me, Yisrael. You can lie to yourself and you can't speak deceit to yourself, but you know what's there. You know the images of your mind. You know what you imagine all the time. It is an imagination of the flesh to please it, to satisfy it. And I don't frankly give a damn if you call me a liar. I speak to you the mind of Almighty Yah, this Yom Shabbat. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But we have received the Ruach, which is of Yah. Why have we received that? That we might, Yah, not know the things that are freely given to us by Yah of Yah. We may know, we don't know what is freely given unto us. That's why we don't pursue the things of Yah. And Yah says the Ruach of Yah is given that we may freely know, that we may understand what Yah has given unto us, YisraYah, what He has freely given unto us in His wisdom and His counsel. Him being the Almighty, the Abba of YisraYah. It is Ruach HaKodesh. It is fear not to cause us to be so trepidated we don't move, but to cause us to tread upon the living waters with great regard and great honor. If Mr. Barack Hussein Obama was traveling on this highway, you're not just going to run up on the man because he is encamped about with the hosts of powerful men that will kill you dead. Yah says it is important you understand my Rachim, because it is the Melech Yah that encamp about you that fear Yah. And if you don't fear Yah, there is no protection for you at all. It is the wisdom of the Avad that caused the son, even though he walked wickedly. There were things that restrained him. I don't give a damn what the daddy did. He proved himself as an Avad with a son. He will see the nature of his strength. I don't give a damn if he walked wickedly. And that's the truth. Before you ever created, before you were ever born, he put it there. And the world did all it could to try to destroy it, to kill it. Hell, you didn't know what was there. And now he sends upon you the Ruach HaKodesh. And then he began to reveal the depths of what hell, not your mama or your daddy put there. Not the prayers of your wife, your sons, and your damn daughters. And he put a damn thing there. He put it there. By his own choice, his own election. And nobody put a damn thing in you. And that's why we can't appreciate him. That's why the world is trying to fill our minds with every kind of a sensual and worldly spirit. That you will root out the very purpose of Yah in our bosom. That's what the world is doing. The mind of Yah must be spoken. We must seek the mind of Yah for every answer. We don't seek the counsel of Yah for answer. That's why he's the mighty counselor. We must seek his mind for everything. We seek our own wickedness of the mind of man, the emotions of man, the sensitivity of man. They don't mean a damn thing, YisraYah. Hallelujah. 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 I shall preach. I wanted to teach, but I'm going to preach and act like a wild thing. Hallelujah. 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 We have not received the spirit of the world. Why? In verse 13, which things also we speak, not according or not in the words which man's wisdom teach. I don't try to teach you some kind of damnable intellectual sermonette. I don't need no plethora of notes to guide you or direct you into a certain mindset. I declare unto you the counsel of Almighty Yah. He said, but that which the Ruach HaKodesh teaches. You tell me the Ruach of Yah teaches? The spirit of Yah, it is a spirit of Murray. It lomads. It teaches us. This is what the Ruach does. It teaches us what? In the wisdom, in the Ruachim, in the knowledge, the da'at, the understanding, in the fear of Yah. That's what the Ruach does. Not this damn thing you call the Holy Ghost. It caused people to strive for sensual and lust for wicked things. Their homes, their cars, their trinkets, their things. And they don't give a damn about the Most High. They're self-grandizing and boasting and what they have, what they're going to get, and what they're doing, their children and their sons and daughters are wicked as hell. the wicked, unclean, the corrupt. But the Ruach HaKodesh, it teaches us the secrets or the lot of Yah. Those things that when we hear them by the messenger, it began to open up that which Yah has not allowed HaShatan to touch. That's why he said with Eob, he said, you can touch him, you can cause sickness, you can afflict Yisrael, you can take them through trials, you can pour out your wrath, but it's one damn thing you're not going to touch. That's the power of the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach, for that was birthed in you before mama even knew. She had nothing to do with it. It was there because Yah put it there. And so the enemy has come with this synthesized false image, this damn faggot freak. That's why faggotism in this damn nation is rampant. This effeminate damn freak of a faggot. And the damn whorehouses today, they're damned. You don't touch these unclean things. We need messengers. We need warriors. We need warriors not like the Gideon warriors. We need warriors like Dawid or like Mahaliah, the warrior of Yah. That's what we need. We need warriors. We don't need boys. We need warriors. Hallelujah. It's fine to be a soldier. It's nice to be a soldier. But we need warriors. Only a select few are warriors. Hallelujah. We need warriors like Uriah. Say, put me on the front line. For it's my delight to die for my Melech. It's a blessing to die for the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. Fools are dying for drugs and say they love each other. And hell, we're not willing to die for him. Hallelujah. I said to Yah this morning, whatever we take to me is fine. I said, Yah, if you let me live, let me be healthy. And if I get where I cannot do anything, just take me on, please. That's my genuine prayer. I don't know about you, but that's my prayer. I'm not afraid of that. I'm not a practitioner of sin and evil works. I don't hoard evil aspiration in my bosom. I'm not a work of deceit and every kind of wicked thing there is. So I have no fear of that. I just say, yeah, I know that I can endure the matter, but take me on out of this realm. For me to live is the testimony of Yahshua to resonate. For me to move, to die, I gain. Either way, I'm enriched. But Yah, if it's thine will, your will be done. In all matters, hear me, Yisrael. Verse 14. It says, but the natural man, the carnal man, the sensual earthly man, receive not the things of the Ruach of Yah. That's why they cannot receive his name. That's why they love their damn Jesus, the damn pagan Baal, their lords. That's why they are trying to, in their own superficial ways of intellectual knowledge and thinking, that they know something that someone else doesn't know, they're saying anything. You got these damn fools today telling folks that they understand that they know the name of the true power, the name of Yah, and they're wicked. They're cowardly, they're sinful, they're vile, they're unclean, and they look unclean. They don't look clean. They look unclean. Their bodies, their minds, their actions, the way they look, it looks filthy. They don't look clean. Their spirit is not clean. The natural mind, this natural mind cannot receive the things of Yah. They cannot be naham. They cannot be bestowed upon this natural mind, because it will bring it to destruction. It will create this convoluted image. The natural mind cannot receive the things of Yahweh because they are foolish to him. The things of Yah are foolish to this generation. You tell a woman how to abide in the beauty of a woman is foolish to them. You speak to a young man how to walk in the beauty of a young man is foolish to him. We're not a people that's honest enough, just like the Akhor last night. And he said to me, I have not learned the way of a husband. I don't know how to be a husband. I don't know how to love my wife. I didn't know how to love her. I thought that having things and buying this and doing that, that was love. But I'm here to tell you it is not love. That is not the appreciation of love. Love is truth. Yah is love. Love is order. Love is discipline. Love is legal. Love is legalistic. A man must be legalistic. A daughter of Tiziah must be legalistic. He cannot permit, she cannot permit, or allow him to go beyond the auspicy of what institution Yah has ordained to satisfy his flesh. Hallelujah. Cannot be, Yisrael. Cannot be. It must be according to the will of Yah. It must be according to Yah's will. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because it is foolish to him, neither can he know them. Why? Because they are spiritually discerned. They are spiritually being or discerned. The knowledge of it, it must come to the revelation, the testimony of power of Yahshua HaMashiach. It must come that way. The things of Yahweh are revealed by the Ruach of Yah. It is the power of his life or his mind. Our minds are natural, they're sensual, they're carnal minds. That's why it doesn't receive the things of Yah. That's why it constantly boasts, and you see that among this damnable dogmatic spirit of what they call Christendom. They're boasting, I'm blessed, I got, I'm getting, I'm having, I got much. They don't have a damn thing. They don't have the spiritual knowledge of Almighty. Even HaShatan can offer you that. He said to Yahshua and Matthias 4 and Lucas 4, he said, bow and worship me. All the kingdom, the riches of it, I'll give it to you. Hell, the damn faggot, the Sodomites got that. You have made us a sugula, a peculiar people, to be different than the damn world. So our excellence is not according to the standards of this damnable religious whore. It's according to the dictates of his doctrine, of his wisdom, of his conscience, his mind that he speaks to us. A father speaks his mind to his son to develop him, doesn't he? Doesn't he? A mother speaks her mind, the Uma, to her being her child, to develop the child. Doesn't she? So who speaks to us? Then Yah. He does that to develop us. To develop our mind. Every daddy wants his son to be like him. If he doesn't, then he's a piece of trash. Even the wicked man. Even though he knows that there are things about him he doesn't like. He doesn't know how to dispel. He will say to his son, don't do this. But he wants his son to have a strength. Even though the man does a certain thing, there's a character strength in the man, and he knows that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He wants him to be the protector of his loin, of his strength. And so when a man is strengthened by the mind of Yah, what man doesn't want his son to be like him? He doesn't give his son over to strangers. A mother, when she understands the beauty of the head of authority, she doesn't want to give her authority or her place of authority to strangers that she doesn't know. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. The mind of Yah speaks to Yisrael this day. These things are foolish. They can only be spiritually being discerned, understood. You can't even consider them unless you have the Ruach HaKodesh. See, it is the damn Holy Ghost that has messed up the people of Yah. We're trying to interpret it by the damn Holy Ghost. Damn the word holy. I know its origins. You can say what you want to. I don't give a damn. Damn the Holy Ghost. Whom the hell wants a ghost should tell your children about a ghost they run. It is his Ruach HaKodesh. Damn the Holy Ghost. Do you hear that? Do I make myself plain? Damn the Baptist Holy Ghost. Damn the Methodist. Damn the white Holy Ghost. Damn the black Holy Ghost. The white Holy Ghost is prejudice, is wicked. It creates a damn image that the damn white preachers will not say that that is racist, is wicked. They promote it. They will not say a damn thing. But if a man of the diaspora speaks against it, then he's racist. He has created some kind of racial tendencies. Damn this white wicked mind, and I will not stop talking about it. It is one of the most damnable, deplorable, wicked things that have caused a scission among all nations of people, and has caused a scission in the Torah of the Word of Almighty. Damn their gods. Damn every god and damn every Baal. Kill me, your will be done. I'm not afraid to say it. I either stand by strength. I'm a cowardly, weak of a man, weakling. And I will not bow down. I will not rescind what I said. Damn them all, for Yah shall damn them. Rise up with your tongue in judgment against me, for I damn your tongue as well. And somewhat of a bold statement, isn't it? I speak to us the mind of Yah. I speak by that mind. Hallelujah. The mind of Yah. Shaul shares with us the tenets of Yah's mind, does he not? Can I move farther? He said, but he that is spiritual, that is led by Yah, is Yah a ruach? Is he a spirit? So when a man is led by Yah, you know that the essence of that man, you know that the essentials of that man's life, it is a spiritual life. It is a life that abides in Torah, delights, it receives the riches, it searches the depths of Torah. He says, but he that is spiritual, he judges all things, not some things, but everything he judges. And yet he himself is judge of no man. He make assessment, he says wrong, he condemns, he damns. And yet his life, the pattern is life, his substance, it is not condemned by any man at all. And all of their gainsaying, they cannot condemn him. And then he asks one of the most profound questions. He makes it an emphatic statement. For who has known the mind of Yah? Who has known his mind? There's only one that has known Yada experience the mind of Yah. For who has known the mind of Yah? That he may give Yah Torah lessons, that he may instruct Yah in Torah. Who has? He said, but we have the mind of YHWH HaMashiach. Is YHWH HaMashiach the Torah made flesh? Is that mind, was it a spiritual mind of revelation of Torah? He says, and you have, who has known the mind of Yah? Only YHWH. Only the Torah, because it is Yah's mind. It is what come out of Yah's bosom. A tough mind. Out of the tough treasures, he brings forth from the abundance of his love. Is Yah tough? Is Yah tough? Sure he is tough. So he has brought out of the abundance of his love the riches of Torah, a spiritual wisdom, knowledge of Torah that was in the pattern of things in the offerings of the bullock, the heifer, and the goat. YHWH hath revealed unto us the lot, the secrets of that, to understand the beauty of that, to understand the power of those offerings. It is only when that testimony become enriched and powerful in us, only then shall we understand the spiritual doctrines of Almighty Yah. That's why we don't understand it, because the power of that is not evident. Can I give us a litmus test that we will know the power that is evident? It is one true sign that YHWH did all things to please Almighty YAH. Examine our own bosom by that katruf. Examine ourselves that way. And we have fallen short. We have chata, sin, willingly, and we have all come short of the mark of the price of the calling, of the high calling of YAH in YHWH. We have missed the mark. So He speaks His mind to us today to show us. To show us His nature, His character, His strength, His power, His beauty, and to show us He means what He says. We must seek the mind of YAH. We must desire to hear the mind of YAH speak. When you don't understand a matter, you seek the mind of YAH. I want to show us what are the most diabolical schemes of hell, what it has done, what it has created among us. I will be forthright. I'm not going to spare not one of us. I don't give a damn about our emotions that are expressed in this juvenile action of emotionalism. I frankly do not give a damn. I'm not concerning whether you send one nickel. That is not my agenda. We must with haste pull those out of the fire whose garments have been seared and singed by the fire. We are at the threshold of the gates of hell. The matter arose among YHWH in the book of YHWH. In every case, we must seek. We may say the will of YAH, but we must seek the mind of YAH. I want to read this. We don't do it. That's why our wicked sons and daughters and our relatives and our kinsmen, they don't give a damn about you and they have no shame of their actions. Can I show you an example, YHWH? We must seek the mind of YAH. Will He reveal His mind? He's revealed His mind to YHWH in a profound way in YHWH. Let us look at this example in the book of YHWH. Leviticus chapter 24. Leviticus 24 and verse 10. Hallelujah. I want to drive one point from here that you will see that is causing death among YHWH, and the power of Hashatan's sin is rampant among the people of YAH. It says here in Leviticus 24 verse 10, it tells us of a son of a Yireelite woman whose father was a Misri. He was of Egypt. He was a Misri. Went out among the children of YHWH, the son of the Yisraelitish woman, and the man, he was of YHWH. And strove, he began to nasa and struggle together in the camp. And the Yisraelitish woman's son, he nakab, he blasphemed. What is to blaspheme? He perforated, denounced the name of YAH. When one speaks the name of YAH, they implore that name. And they will speak the damn Jesus and the damn Lords. I want to show something vital here. We must have the mind of YAH. And so this man, he began to blaspheme. He began to assault the name of YAH with violence.
You speak the name of Yah, they become violent against the beauty of that precious name. They began to make his name despicable. And the more you call on his name, they will call upon their damn. They'll call upon their Lord. They'll call upon their Jesus. He blasphemed. I want to show us something today, Yisrael, what the mind of Yah says. And he blasphemed the name of Yahweh. It did not say he blasphemed the name of the Lord or the gods. He blasphemed the Abba of Yisrael. He strove not, sir. He struggled with them in the midst of the camp. And he blasphemed. He poked holes in his name. He mocked it. He spoke against it. He was violent against the name of Almighty Yah. He struck out at the name. And this wicked generation will strike out when you use that name. They get violently angry. And that is the truth. I don't give a damn if it's mama, daddy, son, daughters. Listen to me. Listen to the word of Yah. He blasphemed the name of Yah, and he kala, he cursed. He said his name doesn't mean a damn thing to you, but not to me. He said his name is despicable. I know the name of my Lord Jesus. It is amazing with many of these dumbfound Negroes, I call them that. That one of the most diabolical scheme of Hashatan has always been language. Words. And words always transform imagery in the mind of man. That is what it is perpetrated for. That's why it is spoken to create that. And yet YHWH came in his Abba's name. And yet this damn twisted generation want to subscribe to a Latin Greek name that doesn't have a damn thing to do with Yah. It doesn't have a damn thing, Yisrael. Not at all. So this child of Belial, he began to blaspheme the name of Yah. He began to kala. He didn't say damn. No, he began to kala. He began to mock. He began to show you how despicable his name was. He began to mock it with ridiculing. And yet the people did not know what to do. He began to kala. He began to curse the name. And so they brought him to Moshe, to the messenger, the Nobi, the Shulishach, the mouthpiece of Yah. The ones whose mind was ordained by Yah. They brought him to Moshe. And his Ima, whose name was Shilemeh. She was one of a peaceful woman. Shilemeh. And the daughter brought him to Moshe. As they brought him, the daughter of Dibri, of the tribe of Dan. Verse 12. And they put this boy in prison. They put him in prison. They segregated him from Yisrael. We don't segregate ourselves from the world. They put him in prison. That the mind of Yah might show them. They put him in prison. That the mind of Yah might show them. They segregated themselves that the mind of Yah might show them. They abandoned him. They separated themselves from him. They put him in a ward. For what reason? That the mind of Yah might be made known. That the mind of Yah might guide them, that the mind of Yah might instruct them. We don't come out from among them. We don't allow the mind of Yah to show us. We are so damnable, wicked, and deplorable. They can speak the actions, the attitudes against you are. And we congratulate, we strengthen. I'm telling you. Woe unto us as a nation, as a people. They segregated themselves from him for one person, that the mind of Yah might show them. In all of their wisdom, their knowledge, they had no ability because there was a natural attachment there. And so they put him aside, removed him out of their presence. It's one thing about the wicked nature of man, the presence of our son, the presence of our ima, the presence of our avatar. We will try to alter the Torah of Almighty Yah. But they said, as the voice of the messenger said, put him in prison. Shackle him and put him in the ward. For what reason, Moshe? That the mind of Yah may show us. The mind of YHWH has shown us. That is the mind of Yah. That is the mind of Yah. He is who knows the mind of Yah, that he may instruct him. Who can counsel Yah? But we have the mind of YHWH HaMashiach. They put him in prison. Was not YHWH put in the prison of the earth? That the mind of Yah might show us the beauty and the riches of the power of that death. And to this day, we don't know a damn thing because we're wicked as hell. We're vile. We stink with the dung. He put him in the earth 3 days and three nights in the belly, as Yonah in the belly of the whale, that his mind might be known, that he will show us how he's going to deal with the wicked, that we don't have to fight the battle. He has already won it for us, YHWH. The mind of Yah must speak unto his people. We need messengers that search out the depths and the riches of the knowledge of Yah's Torah. It is time out, YHWH. And we play around and satisfy our damn flesh with folly and triviality. That doesn't mean a damn thing. You can't sit and play a damn game for 3 hours. You silly man, you stupid bimbo of a woman. Hallelujah. We can sit with all kind of laughter. I want you to hear this. He blasphemed the mind. He blasphemed the character. He blasphemed the personality. He blasphemed the name of Almighty Yah. We don't separate ourselves from those that blaspheme his name, that Yah may reveal his mind to us. They separated themselves that the mind of Yah might show them. See, our minds show us to operate in a fashion that is conducive unto our natural emotions. But Yah's mind calls us to operate in his compassion and in his emotions. So they separated themselves from him that Yah's mind may be known. Show us. We need to separate ourselves from our wicked flesh. That's why YHWH commands us to impel, to destroy, to break down, to destroy the affections, the desire of our flesh and our ruach, that we may perfect the kadosh nature of Yah in us, in the ruach that is chodesh, that is set apart. And we don't separate ourselves from our greeds, our lusts, our grandizing ways, the thing that drive us. We don't separate ourselves from that. That's why we are weak and wicked and beggary. We are insignificant in the whole scheme of the world today. And that is a damn shame. They said, get out, boy. We want to see what the mind, the leban, the conscience, the thoughts, the judgment, the doctrines of Yah speaks to us. So they separated him that the mind of Yah might show them. And Yah spoke unto Moshe, saying, Yah spoke unto me this week, last week, today, yesterday. He spoke by the enriching of the testimony of Yahshua as I turned the pages of the Shefar, and the revelation of his truth caused my bosom to delight. Hallelujah. But Yah spoke unto Moshe. This is Yah. It doesn't have a damn thing to do with you or me. And Yah spoke unto Moshe, saying, bring forth him that has kala, that has cursed, that have spoken in once indignant fashion. Yah said, take him out of the camp. We want to keep them in the camp. Yah said, the one that has cursed, that has kala, that has made my name despicable, that has not strove in the midst of YHWH, he said, take him outside of the camp. He said, I want everyone that heard this bastard slip, this child of hell, I want them to lay their hands upon his head, that the witness of your testimony, your edotha, would be a witness of truth. Lay hands on him. Hallelujah. He said, I want everybody to lay hands on this child of hell. Lay hands on him. I want the testimony in the mouth of two or three witnesses to seal the fate of my mind. Lay hands on his head. He said, and let all the entire congregation. He said, I want you to kill him. I want you to stone the bastard and kill him. This is a generation of vipers. It is an evil generation. It is a wicked and an adulterous generation. No one is going to warn them to flee, as Yahchanan said, to flee the wrath of Yah that shall come. Because they're not willing to bring forth fruits of teshuva, of repentance. They're not ready to shuv. They're not ready to turn around. That's why we are continuously caught up, succumb to all of our wicked ways that constantly overpower us. Something is wrong. That mind of yours is wicked. You have not sought the mind of Yah in any matter. They knew that because there was an attachment to the Israelite woman. They knew the beauty of her husband. They saw his strength. They saw his character in the midst of YHWH. And this boy is acting like a damn fool. We have come out of the seed of Abraham through Yishak and Yaakov. And yet our ways are childish and full of folly. We kalaya. We have no regard for the strength and the beauty of his name. Yah said, let the witness be established. Bring him outside of the camp. And I want everyone to stone him. And that when every stone is cast, it will be a monument. You won't be able to remove them. And it will be a witness unto you, YHWH. You don't blaspheme the name of Yah. When a man hears the name and they constantly reject it, I will show you the end of that one. I want to show us something that is profound today. We need to hear the mind of Yah about the matters. Yah said, kill him. Destroy him. Is he still compassionate? Is he full of love? For Yah so loved the lamb that he gave Yahshua. Is he full of love? He is love. I don't give a damn whether you like it. This is Yahshua here. Is he not the stone that the builders rejected? And now he has become the chief cornerstone. We have rejected the premises of Torah. That's what this religious whore does today. Oh, you don't have to do that, sir. I was with a businessman the other day that I've dealt with in the past. And he says to me that my perception of you were quite legalistic. I said, my friend, Yah is legal. Everything he says is legalistic. He has a legal mandate, my friend. He's not going to buy the damnate, Jesus. And I talk like this. And through this subtlety of hell, they blaspheme the name of Yah. They mock his name. And they say it's all right. It's not all right. I don't give a damn who it is. Get him out of the camp. And kill him dead. Well, Yah has changed. You're a damn liar. He doesn't change. Well, if this theme doesn't run concurrently throughout the book, then he has changed, all right? If I cannot show you the concurrency of this theme, even unto Gilgana Revelation, then Yah has changed. I will move with some expediting of time. Hallelujah. Yah says, let the congregation stone him. Yah says to Moshe, and you shall speak to the being, the children, my elect, of Yisra'iah, saying, I want you to hear this, whosoever curses Kala to cause the name of Yah to be despicable, whosoever curse Yah shall bear his sin. So the fate of this one, whosoever shall blaspheme the name of Yah, you shall bear the same sin of this Yisraelite son. You should bear your own sin. Well, that's not so. Well, unless it is concurrent throughout the Katveh, then what Yah said is not the truth. And we know let Yah be truth and every man be a liar. It's by his immutability, no power to change. Even if he wanted to change, he could not change. That Yah cannot lie. He cannot speak a shekah. Every principle of Yahshua and the renewed covenant is based upon the principle of Torah. Everything he said. Every Nobi, whether it was Hanach, I don't care who it was, Yetzah, it is all based upon Torah. Yah says, whosoever shall curse Yah shall bear his sins. And he that blasphemes a nachab or speak with a despicable wickedness against Yah's name, the name of Yah, he shall be surely put to death. Muth. He shall be separated from Yah. This blasphemy separation is the theme that I shall show us throughout the directives of Torah, that it runs throughout the whole book. Can one get forgiveness for blasphemy if they blaspheme against the Ruach? Is he the Ruach? And what the Ruach is, it is simply Yah's breath in us. It is the breath of Yah in us. It is the life of his testimony. You're not going to get forgiveness. And I will show you the mind of Yah on this sin that many are doing. And we as Yisra'iah, we don't separate ourselves from them. We give them credence. We give them strength. Yah said, take them out of the camp. And let your testimony against the child of hell, let it stand, Yisra'iah. We must do it. We're not going to get by. He says, and he that blasphemes the name of Yah shall surely be put to death, and the congregation shall certainly stone him as well. Yah say, even the strangers, those that are not of the house of Yisra'iah, they shall kill this fool, that insidious mind shall not creep in among them. He said, even the gore, the strangers, as he that is born in the land, when he blasphemed the name of Yah, he shall be put to death. I want to say this, Yisra'iah, with a candid honesty. That is one thing that the whore has taught us. It has placed the spirit of blasphemy to kala the name of Yah. Even when I began to teach on that name many years ago, that even when I began to mention it, people will become perturbed with that. They began to rise up because it is the nature of blasphemy. And they didn't want to hear that. They would get upset. They would get mad. Look at this little small gathering here today. Hell, there are men today that don't even have a percentage of the tenacity that I have. And the place is packed. And they will teach things that are so relative, mucus, that there is no strength of the people at all, but they will pack the house out. There are those that have live streams that people cannot even get on because there are so many wanting to watch. But a true messenger, the one that speaks the mind of Yah, many don't want to hear that. Because it goes against everything that they believe. And so by the birth of this whore, that her birth was to assault Yah and come against him and to sow the seed or the spirit of blasphemy. Because Yah knows that when one blasphemes his name, he cannot go back on his word. He or she must die. They must die. They must die. And they shall die. And they blaspheme the name of Yah. Well, it's Mama. Mama cannot harden her heart when she hears the truth. As in the days when they provoke Yah. You speak the truth, YHWH, and you don't lie against Almighty Yah. If they receive it, you barak. You pour the shalom of Yah upon them. If they reject this name, you shake the dust off of your feet. And don't even dock on that damn wicked house. And that is the truth. Take him out of the camp that the mind of Yah may be known. Yah, we want to know your mind today in all matters. They shall destroy him. When he blasphemed the name of Yah, he shall be put, or muth, he shall be put to death. From the conception and the beginning of sin, man began to blaspheme and speak ill against Yah. There was one mother named Hanach, Enoch, as he began to teach his son Methuselah of the things that shall be, the time that shall be, and one of the most powerful spirits of this time, he began to teach his son of that matter. I want to read precisely today, emphatically, that you may hear and you may understand and see if this is the characteristic of this time, or we're walking in this time. As Hanach exposed unto us in the book of Enoch, Hanach chapter 24, verse 12. I want to begin reading. Hanach 91, verse 1. The book of Hanach. As he admonishes children, he taught them emphatically, you must hear the mind of Yah in every matter, that you can reason with him, because you reason with his mind. That's why he says, come and let us reason together. Because he knows that you're going to come to the same resolution that he has already ordained. And when we get that mind of Yah, when we speak with the mind of YHWH, we can reason with Yah. That's why YHWH said, he said, oh my Abba, this thing of death, it is an unbearable thing, but not my will, but your will be done. Let it be so, Yah, your will be done. And out of his bosom, he raises up this powerful Nobi. They shall not even see Muth, death. They shall never be separated from him. But he was caught up and did not see death. His name was Hanach Enoch. And he gives us a descriptive of the time and how we prepare the mind. Prepare ourselves to walk in the mind of Yah. Hanach chapter 91 verse 1. He declares, now my son Methuselah, please summon all your brothers on my behalf, tell them I command their presence before us. Is not that what Yahshua did? He commanded us. Has he not summoned all of his brothers on Yah's behalf? That's what he did, Yisra'iyah. Our minds are so shoddy and shot because of sin. Every act in Torah, in the book, it's Yahshua HaMashiach. He came to call no one but the lost house or the sheep of Yisra'iyah. My sheep, they know my voice. And so when he sent Methuselah to summon his brothers, they knew that this was the cry of the Avat. He said, tell my sons to come and gather together to me all my sons of your mother. For a voice calls me, the voice of Yah, the mind of Yah. Out of the abundance of the land, the Feth speaks. Out of the top treasures, the Feth, the voice speaks. He said, out of his heart, Yah calls me, and the Ruach is poured over me. Why? Was Yahshua filled, or the Ruach of Yah was poured out upon him with measure or without measures? With measures or without measures? Without measures. Without measures. We see the pattern that substantiates throughout Torah. He said that the Ruach poured over me so that I show you not some things, but everything that shall happen to you forever. Olam v'et is perpetual. It is antiquity. It is eternal. It is without time. That is what Olam v'et implies. He said, the things that shall come, even though we are here, you shall see this thing. Then Methuselah went and he summoned his ach, and having summoned them to him, gathered his family, his mishpah, the family together. Then Hanak spoke to them all. First of all, he addressed them. He says, children of Sadakah, you're the children of righteous. You are the children of the characteristics of Yah, for you have the mind of Yah. I speak by the mind of Yah. I feed you the mind of Yah. I feed you the bread of his mind. Yahshua is the Lutzim of Yah. He's the bread of Yah's mind. That's why Shaul said, but we have the mind of Yahshua HaMashiach. He said, I want you to Shema, hear, all you children of Hanak, the talk of your father, and listen to my voice in uprightness. Don't allow your mind, don't allow the mind or the spirit of man to reject what I say. Don't reject what I say today. Has nothing to do with association and your infatuation with those of them of that one. It has to do with what Yah says. He said, listen to my voice in uprightness. He said, I implore you, I exhort you, I command you, my beloved, and I say to you, love above all, love uprightness. What is just, what is right to do, love that. He said, love uprightness. He says, and it alone. Is the mind of Yah upright? Is his mind upright? Is the Torah upright? She was upright. Was Yahshua upright? Did he walk upright? Did he walk clean? Did he walk right? Did he walk straight? And you love uprightness alone. Just love that, because that is the mind of Yah. Love the mind of Yah. Don't reject the mind of Yah. He says, love uprightness. Rightness. Love that, Yisra'iyah. Do not draw near. Do not draw near uprightness. Don't associate as even as Moshe did. Don't associate uprightness with ambivalent. You understand what one is ambivalent is? It is one that is uncertain. They don't know. When one is ambivalent, they don't know what they're doing. This religious world doesn't know what it's doing. So you don't associate the uprightness of Yah, the uprightness of the Torah, with ambivalence, as to say, I don't know if the Torah means that. I don't know if the Torah implies that. With an ambivalent attitude, and neither associate with hypocrites. Those that despise the name of Yah, that call his name despicable, that reject his truth, that's a hypocrite. Those that are pretenders, pretending that they are right and they're doing every kind of damnable, wicked sin there is, that's a hypocrite. He said, don't even gather with them. That's what he said. Put him in bondage. Take him out of the camp. I don't even want him to die in the midst of the camp. Take him out. But walk in Sadiq, my children, and it shall leave you in the tough paths or the derek or the righteous derek of Yah, and righteousness shall be your friend. The Sadiq of Yah shall be our friend. You tell me that should be the friend of YHWH. We should love to hear what Yah speaks. Did what Yah, the mind of Yah, as Moshe sought the mind of Yah to show them, was he right in what he did? Sure, he was right. You don't have to answer, but he is still right. He was right in what he did. So we should love the Sadiq of Yah, the righteousness, and we ought to want to be his friend. Yahshua says unto us, he said, I call you no more evet or servants, I call you friends. For servant knows not what his master does, so I call you friend. Was he righteous? Was he righteous? So he calls us friends, right? So the Torah is righteous. Everything that Yah does, his mind does, it is righteous. It is right. You don't have to understand that. As the old ones would say, in the progressive motion or the progressive ways of Yah, you will learn by and by when we overcome. So when you overcome what? Flesh, your own will, your own infatuation, you will learn, you will understand, YHWH. You will understand. I want to make this play. I want to teach us today. I want to holler and preach. Hallelujah. He says this so with such powerful oratorical insight. Hanukkah 91:5. He says, for I know, I yada, I've experienced Yah, I know that the state of Hamas, of violence, of cruelty, will intensify upon the earth. What a Jezebel of a bitch. And I say that. This thing in Florida that murders her baby. And a violent jury lets her walk. When their young men of the diaspora, I recall when we were going to the federal prison. A young man had been there for 13 years because he had just a few rocks of crack. And he had been in prison for 13 years. And yet this fleecing Jezebel of emotions, this sluttish whore, a beer guzzle, woman kissing, tongue licking woman, yet the nation raised hell and uproar when the violent acts of O.J. Simpson was revealed. In every jurisdiction pursued the man until they put him in prison for 20 years for minor offense. And yet this slut of a whore, this damn wicked child of hell, we see it everywhere. The violence of these radical homosexual dogs, these freaks and these lesbian, gays, transgenders. They are in the whorehouses to the full. They're in the Baptist whole house, the Methodist whole house, the Catholic whole house, the Jewish whole house, the Pentecostal, the Lutheran. They're in these damnable, twisted Christendom doctrines of hell. They are there. And yet among those that declare or pronounce that they are the true lineage of the Hebrew Israelites, you see the infiltration of every kind of damn wicked spirit that is imaginable unto the mind of man, because they're violent against Yah. And when a messenger declares their sins, they don't want to hear that. I turn the dial, you can go from here to there. You will never hear about the Hatzah of Israel. So I'm a reject. I'm a retarded man, but that's all right. I'm going to die this way. I want to die this way. I don't hold nothing back. Don't take it back. To my own damnation, to my own judgment. I'm a partaker of this. That's why I don't do a lot of things, because I don't want to catch me with my feet somewhere that they ought not. Should be. So I stay at home. I like being at home. That's me. He says, I want you to understand the state of Hamas will intensify. The violence of this nation, the brutality and the brutal cruelty of Hamas. It is a cruel nation that robs, kills, pillage. They're killing your sons. They're killing your babies. They're creating a violence in their mind to rise up against Yah with the videos, the movies. They indoctrinate them in the houses of demonic power in the movie houses. They become so slick in their activities. They produce it right over the internet into your home. You can watch some of the most deplorable, most wicked type of activities. You can sit at home and they take your money and they cause you to react violently against your Ishah, your Ish, your Bain, and those that you call your friend, because it is the power of HaShatan to shape the mind. We are not seeking the mind of Yah on the matter to show us. And the only way you would do that, it must be a constant refreshing of Torah, of the spiritual Torah, the laws of Yah, the ordinance, the stipulations, the statutes of Yah. We must constantly refurbish, revive ourselves daily, every hour, meditating in the word of Yah. If you don't eat today, listen, I know I'm preaching, but I'm hungry. I have not put anything in my belly this morning. So I am hungry. You may fast, but the thing that you want after you fast is what? You want a food. You want to eat. And so as we deny ourselves our activities to endeavor to the Torah, we want to eat from the Torah. And then after we fast seeking to understand when it's all right to sit down and have a sandwich and eat. I want to make this of the simplest format I can to drive home that we must seek the mind of Yah in the matters. And Yah must speak. And we must hear the mind of Almighty Yah. He said that violence will intensify upon the earth, and great plagues shall be executed upon the earth. And he uses this word, and all forms of oppression, the demonic powers or oppressing, shall be carried out, and everything shall be uprooted. There is nothing that is sacred today. We are not sincere with Yah. The smallness of the pursuit of the wicked after us, we will uproot ourselves from the Torah. We will coddle them. We will do what it takes for their association. We will be ashamed of his name. We'll be ashamed of our garment. We'll be ashamed of Yahshua. Damn the wicked. I don't give a damn if it's my mama, my daddy. I don't give a damn. Yeah. It's one thing that Yah put in me from day one, although I was ignorant as a fool. He put a fire down in my inward parts. And I did not give a damn who stood with me. I didn't give a damn what the mama, kinsmen, my relatives, and they all turn against me. And I don't give a damn to this day. You can, but I don't give a damn. I will stand for you. Kill me in the battlefield like Uriah. Take my last breath here, Yah. I mean that. For me to live is the power of YHWH, that testimony, to rise in me in everything I do. And if I die, I gain the promises of Yah. Don't have to labor no more. Listen, if you think that this is not a tremendous form of laboring here, you are a fool. If you all think that it doesn't exact from me spiritually above all, and even physically, even my physical mass, it exacts from that. Hallelujah. There's something past when I've been here for 2 hours nearly, standing, talking, and yelling, that I may sound the alarm in Yerushalayim, that you may hear this blasphemous whore that has taught us to blaspheme his name. He's going to kill you and destroy you. And that's the truth. Hallelujah. He said, everything that shall be uprooted, it shall be uprooted. And every arrow shall fly fast. Look at the arrows today. We should have emunah. Why? Why do we need the faith? Why do we need the faith of Yah? That we may quench all the fiery darts of our shatan. When he fires, they're coming fast. You don't even know which way to turn today. We don't even know how to respond to matters because we're not inquiring of the mind of Yah. The dots are coming. Have faith that is battered. It is shattered. We don't even have faith to stand up against the walls of hell. We need the emunah that we may quench. He said, the time shall come that the violence of Satan, the darts shall come, the arrows. They're going to come in such repetition that you're just going to give up and die. You're going to give way to your sin. Well, that's all right. No, it's not all right. Because Yah says it's not all right. I will prove the matter as I continue. Hallelujah. Oppression shall recur once more and be carried out upon the earth under the masterful power of hell, the government of oppression, that we are so confused in our minds, the world is. They don't know what is head, and they don't know what is tail. They don't know up from down, a nation and people, a world that doesn't know right from wrong. He said every form of oppression, injustice, and iniquity of on shall infect the world twofold. If you say anything about the Torah of Yah, people will say you're legalistic. They will say you're legalistic. I am legalistic because Yah is the legal owners of this earth. My vessel is no more my own. I have been purchased by the dumb, the price of YHWH HaMashiach. I'm not free to do what I want to do with it. And what I choose to do with my own body, it produced death, hell, and a stench that I can't even forbear. I recall as a young 21-year-old young man, young fool, as my life was oppressed and tormented because I was running from Yah. And even though he allowed this whore, even a whore can produce pity milk, he said, I'll bring you along, son. You just hold fast to truth. I've never been a rejecter of truth. I've never fought men because of things I didn't understand. I've never tried to rail and to show them what they did not know. I've never. It has not been part of my character or my makeup. I would always listen. And if I didn't know, I didn't know. And if I knew, that I would seek the counsel of the mind of Yah, and it would come to pass. And when I spoke on it, you would know that you are wrong, Yisrayah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oppression and every kind of sin, it shall increase. Hallelujah. And iniquity. People, their minds are Torah-lessness. There's no delight in Torah. There is no mind of Yah being made known. Yahshua spoke with the mind of Yah. He spoke out of the power of Torah. You cannot have the mind of Yah with doctrines of Christendom. You cannot have the mind of Yah esteeming a damn Jesus and you blaspheme the name of the Most High. You cannot. He says, when sin, oppression, and he points out one of the most profound things, blasphemy, and injustice, increase, crime, iniquity, and uncleanliness shall be committed and increase likewise. I will read that again. Hear this, Yisra'iyah. He said, when sin, what is sin? It is transgressing the Torah. It is defying the Torah. He said, when sin and oppression, the demons are oppressing us, just like the woman was oppressed by the demons, and the demons oppress the Shadema, oppress our minds. When sin, when oppression and blasphemy, when they blaspheme the name of Yah, that's why he's going to turn to a people with a pure language that will call upon his name out of a pure language. When sin, oppression, and blasphemy and injustice, this is a nation that is unjust. She is a nation that her credence are of injustice. What a dirty whore. For 30 days, the baby dead. This dirty little flees to Jezebel. And yet a woman of the color that even spake their child, they go to prison. They didn't even charge her with child abuse. This damnation of injustice. That young, rich Caucasian man that had killed those people in Florida with his car, he sent money to their family, would not serve one damn day in jail. Yet doctors kill people every day. And yet the man that prescribed Michael Jackson a little something, he'll go to prison. This is a nation that is full of injustice. Crime in the communities everywhere. Sin is rampant. Because there's blasphemy in the mouths of the people. They go to the damn pagan whorehouses on Yom Rishon. And they cry the damn Jesus, Jesus, Lord, Lord. And they cry the damn Christo, their Christ. Damn their Christ. And yet they come from the whorehouses of Horam. And they commit every kind of damn sin it is. They transgress the Torah. They don't zakah ha-shabbat and shema chadosh. They don't keep the Shabbat. They have taken the name of Yah in vain. Yah say, you're not going to be guilty, you dirty dog. When this boy of the Yisraelite woman took the name of Yah in vain, we kalah, when he blasphemed the name of Yah, Yah said, kill him. When they sought the mind of Yah, they killed him. It would be better you've never heard the name than to hear it and to blaspheme it. Again, he said, when sin, oppression, blasphemy, and injustice increase, when that increase, then we will see crime, they're killing, they're destroying. You will see iniquity, you will see a mind of Torahlessness. These whorehouses with 10,000 will be there tomorrow. These damn reputed houses of prostitution, they will come, the women dressed like a Jezebel, a whore that's selling her wares. The effeminate men of no strength at all. They will serenade themselves in the midst of their irreputed houses of every kind of damn whoredom there is. He said, when crime and iniquity and uncleanness shall be committed and increase likewise. He said, when you see that, he said, Yisra'iyah, he said, sons, then a great plague shall take place from Hashemayim upon these. He says, Yah the Kadosh, the Kodesh, sovereign master, shall emerge. He's going to stand up. He's going to emerge with wrath, with his ath, with his wrath, with wrath and plague, in order that he may execute his mishpatim, his judgment upon the earth. He says in the book of Gilgal, he said, I'm going to destroy them in Revelation, that destroy my earth. It is a plight on the earth today, a plague. Because the mind is lawless. We're not seeking the mind. And we as Yisra'iyah, we're pursuing the same devilish, wicked activities of the world. We're doing the same damn things the world is doing. We're carrying out some of the most egregious activities that one can imagine. We are filthy, we are vile, we are insensitive, and we are cruel. We don't give a damn about Yah. His HaMashiach that has paid the ultimate price for us. He is not even in our lips. But every kind of vile thing is there. We allow individuals just to perforate and to smite him. Oh, the Lord Jesus, damn your Lord Jesus. When I get around people, they will use that around me. You understand? They know how I talk. The businessman the other day, well, you know, I know his name is Yah. It's amazing what he said. You'll be surprised the people that go to our website. He said, I know you all have one of the largest websites out there. It's not one out there that is more informative and as large as yours website. Or even my enemies, they venture in to check on me. I appreciate you, my enemies. Listen, for your own damnation and your own judgment. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's going to commit. He's going to perform his judgment. Verse 8, in those days, injustice shall be cut off from its source of succulent fountains and from its roots. Likewise, oppression together with deceit, with Shekhar lies. Was not Hashatan the father of deceit? His oppression with deceit, they shall be destroyed from under Hashemaim. Then the Sadiq one shall arise from his sleep, and the wise one shall arise, and he shall be given unto them, the people, and through him the root, only through Yahshua, shall the root of oppression be cut off. Sinners shall be destroyed. How? By the sword they shall be cut off together. With who? With the blasphemers. Sinners are going to be cut off with the blasphemers. We blaspheme the name of Yah. We despise it. We got these damn fools out here today that they will say his name is I Am, I Am. Well, hell, they're so damn ignorant. They're jackasses of ignoramuses. You can do research. I got 1,000 scriptures over there showing you the implication of the word Chaya. I am that I am. To come, to be, come forth. These are jackasses of individuals. They easily deceive. It takes a silly man. Anytime a man stands up before the people and laughs, he's a damn silly clown. I was listening to a man this morning teaching in the name, and yet he was so damn silly. All you could hear was laughter. Sporting. That's not the mind of Yah. Well, Yah laughs is because of the damn calamity, because you rejected him. He's going to laugh at you at your calamities. Because you will reject truth and deny truth. He's going to mock you when your fear comes as a whirlwind. He's going to laugh at you when there is nowhere to turn. So you find men like that. You find silly boys around them. They have no strength or beauty. They have no chadosh nature. They're not even men with the character of Yah. They're weak emblems of boys. I like men. I got a man's thing. I want to be around men. I don't like being around the boys. I will play with boys, and that's it. Not long, because I don't want the boy to think that he has a play toy. Those said, you play with a dog, he'll lick you. He will definitely lick you. And he will try to lick you in your mouth, all right? It's amazing that people care more for damn dogs than they do one another. They'll be so concerned, they will house a dog, they will hug and they kiss it, and hell, they don't even know how to hug each other. What a damn hypocrite. They will bring an unclean thing like a damn dog to live in their house. Damn every dog. That's right. Get the damn dogs out of your house. You shouldn't have a damn dog living in the house with you. The same individual will see an ach and a hot that's in need of help. They will not even let them come stay with them. But they will put a damn dog there. Hallelujah. No Rottweiler is going to live with me and my woman. No, he's not living in the house. I make you a nice house out there, Roddy. And I'll put you in as far as you come trouncing and walking through my house. I don't care if you're a little Roddy or a big Roddy. You all stink. You all have fleas. I don't give a damn. Kick the damn dog out. That's what we need to get the damn dog spirit out. We were the most concerned. Folks, I watch folks let damn dogs lick them in the mouth. And you want to kiss them there? Kiss me here. Damn you. Damn you, you wicked thing. I will, my friend. I'm not afraid of this damn wicked generation. We have assaulted the Most High. We have blasphemed Him. We have turned our backs on Him. That's why we are backsliders. We've turned our buttocks to His face. You don't have a damn thing on us when we say to Him, tell me my wrong. He says, as YHWH, He's already told me you're wrong. We're damn hypocrites. And we don't want to be told we're hypocrites. We want to be told we're nice and sweet. We're not nice and sweet. We're cruel individuals. Hallelujah. Is it still all right to preach, my friend? Preach. All right, then I will. Sinners shall be destroyed by the sword. They shall be cut off altogether with the blasphemers in every place. Every damn blasphemer will prove the point. That's when we must seek them out of Yah. When those blasphemers in the midst, they're going to cause every kind of wicked practitioner to arise in the midst, Yisrael. That's why YHWH needs to rise up in our bosom. And cut them off. The spirit of His might, of the power of Yah, you rise up and say, nah. We were out the other day and I stopped to get some vegan sausages. There are only a few places you can buy a certain kind for the ark. He was very kind, very cordial. He came to my issue and I and said, you guys need help. I didn't respond. And so he walks away. I didn't even respond. And so I said, I can't let him get by with that. So I went to the man. I said, how are you doing, sir? My name is Dave Roberts. How are you, sir? Fine. My name is this. I said, okay. And we began to talk. And when I began to explain things to him, he said, I appreciate that, man. He said, this is my son here. He said, that's what we're about. His son, very regal-looking young man, strong, and very charming about his son, about what he's tall as a king better be. Both the men were tall. Of course, I'm a nub. But he said, I appreciate that, your instructions. He didn't fight. And we are people that fight against the mind of Yah. Even a mind of the natural conscious desire growth. You would think that we want to get up and grow. Hallelujah. We want to grow up and get strong. You would think that, but we don't, Yisrael. He's telling us what shall be the sign. This time what shall be. Sinners shall be cut, shall be destroyed, and the sword shall cut off altogether the blasphemers in every place. And those who design oppression, listen now, when those design oppression, they're going to commit blasphemy. That is what the Christian whore did. Even in this nation, she designed oppression. She told those that were under the rod of the yoke on their necks and under the rod of oppression, that this is the name, and there were those that came out of the diasporas, the people of the true Hebraic lineage, not all of them, but they were the true sons of Yisrael, and they tried through generations to eradicate the name and give them a damn false Jesus, a blasphemous name, to eradicate that among the children, to take away the riches of the power of Yah, and hell, everyone today call upon a damn pagan name. We were oppressed. There was oppression. And when oppression is, there's blasphemy. When there's oppression, I will show you this in the book. Oh, you're reading out of the book of Hanukkah, but I will read it in the book of Revelation. I'll read it in what we call the renewed covenant. We need students of the Torah, men that will labor. I'm not talking about hen peckers. Peck here, peck there. No, man, we need men to sit down. I don't give a damn how ignorant you are. I don't care how unlearned you are. I'm of all men an unlearned man. I know that. I'm not wise in my own conceit to think that I'm a learned man. So I must labor. I must labor. And any time you put laboring and effort in anything, there shall be a reward. I don't care what you do. I don't give a damn what you do. You may not can walk a mile, but if you put labor and effort, you will get to the mile. You will get there. You may not know how to read or write. If you want to learn how to read or write, you learn one word, you will get there. Time out for your damn weak beggary excuses. In time we grow up, even children don't make excuses. You can't do that. No, I can do it, Mama. No, Mama, please, but Daddy, let me do it. Let me do it. I know it's the truth. We don't even have the minds of children. Daddy, I can do Daddy. No, Daddy. No. That little bone head, sometimes we're doing something. I say, let me, oh, Papi. Because he wants to do it. Papi, let me do it. I can do it. I say, boy, okay, go ahead. And yet we as adults, we that are mature, we can't even do it. We can do all things through Yahshua HaMashiach that gives us strength, Yisrael. What is the strength? The revelation of Torah. He brings it alive. Hell, that's what his koach is. The Torah is vibrant. It has substance in us. We cannot continue to digress from you. We must seek the mind of you on the matter. Well, Raah Dawid said that we'll seek the mind of you on the matter. Let him show you your damn wickedness. Let him show you your shortcomings. He will show you that. How? What are you chosen to save us? You've chosen by the foolishness of preaching to save them that believe. I look foolish up here. That's his methodology, not your methodology. How can you even hear the Torah of Yah unless you have a preacher? And a man that preaches, he must be sent by the Ruach. He must be sent by Yah. You must hear what Yah says. He said, because of the blasphemers, the design, who design oppression, and those who design oppression, and those who design oppression and commit blasphemy shall perish like the knife. They're going to be destroyed. The blasphemers, those that have eradicated the name of Yah and given it a Latin, a Greek name, given it a Baal name, and those that do not seek the mind of Yah. I will speak his mind quickly here in the book of Enoch in the 96th chapter. You must hear this in order to hear what I will get to, Yisrael. I have 6 pages here. I know I'm not going to finish today because this exacts an enormous amount of energy. And I'm going to stop at a place that next week I will finish. All right? This takes too much out of me. All right? When I try to do this for 3 hours, I am not worth anything until maybe Yom Shuddei, Monday. I'm not worth a dime when I go home, and that's just the truth. We're dealing with powers and princes and forces of hell. And on next week, I'm going to take us into the depths of things, seeking the mind of Yah and the spirit of blasphemy, what it has done, Yisrael, and the rewards. The one that blasphemed the name of Yah in the midst of the camp of Yisrael. You must, that is one thing you must seek the mind of Yah on, and that is blasphemy. You must. And they sought the mind of Yah to show them what to do. You must do that. Hallelujah. And that is the truth, Yisrael. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In the book of Hanak, hallelujah, Enoch. In the book of Enoch, again, chapter 96, I began reading. Woe Unto you that carry out oppression, you suppress the people. You malign them, you abuse them, you rob. I was reading an article yesterday, and the article said that the unemployment is at 9.2%. But the article was on the crises of unemployment among the people of the diaspora, the diasporas, the people of color, that it is at the heights of the Great Depression. And I'm talking about people with legitimacy that looking for jobs and will work any kind of job. They're not there to be found. Why is it that there is always a people oppressed to a magnitude of that nature? Why is that? Because blasphemy is in the nation. And it's one thing the mind of Yahweh show any people, even the stranger. Yah says, he said to Moshe, I want the stranger to stone that bastard slip. He said, I want the stranger to kill him because they will understand the justness of my judgment. You understand? He said, kill the dirty bastard. And even strangers from the commonwealth of Yisra'iyah, they will know what is just to do. It's only those that blaspheme. Yah said that conscience, it is a conscience that is my enemy. It can never be altered, and it can never be changed. Kill it, get it out, bind it, put it in ward. And that's what we must do, but we don't want to do that. And that is the truth. This nation is a nation of oppression. It oppresses the people. And even those that have oppressed, they shall be oppressed. Believe me. Those that have led into captivity, Shibuth, have brought men into shackles of bondage, they shall be brought or led into captivity as well. They're going to be brought under the yoke of the shackles. And that's the truth. Yah is not mocked. Don't be deceived. He rained this down upon the children of the generation. He said, the Yisra'iyah, he says, your fathers. And you're going to pay for what your Avat has done. Hallelujah. The book of Hanok says here in 96, chapter 96, verse 7. Woe unto you who carry out oppression, deceit, and blasphemy. Is this not the nature of HaShatan? That he oppresses the Sadiq? That he is one that is full of shekha, lies, and corruption? When he speaks a lie because there is no imat, no truth in him. Woe unto you who carry out oppression, deceit, and blasphemy, that blaspheme the name of Yah. I want to drive this home. That blaspheme the name of Yah. There shall be a record of evil against you. Yah says, evil shall come upon you. And that is one thing that this Christian OS done. It brought people here in this nation and told them through the blasphemy, lies, the deceit, that it's all right for you to be oppressed. It is the will of their God for you to be in shackles. It is the will of God because you are cursed. It is the will of God for you to be bound. It is the will of God for you to serve us. Damn their God. Damn every God. And they oppress the people. They bound them the shackles. And they lied and they told them a damn blasphemous name against the Most High. Call upon our damn Jesus. That's what they did. I don't take one word back. I don't rescind what I say. Hallelujah. So they oppress the people. Woe unto them. See the record of your oppression, the record of your lies, and the record of your blasphemy. In this wicked nation of 300 million, this has been the roots of Christianity. Hell, the Catholic hole would be nothing without the resources other money is coming from this dirty hole. From this dirty hole. The Vatican cannot survive and carry out its manipulating blasphemy. This last dirty bastard, this Pope, he said that the name of Yahweh must be eradicated out of all, I have the article, Catholic literature. They know his name. And they've given us a damn phony name and a false name of blasphemy. When you have oppression, deceit, and blasphemy, Yah says, there shall be a record of evil against you. Yah says, I have ordained evil against you. Was that the pattern with Moshe and the young man? Sure it was. Yah said, lay hands, put him outside of the camp, and kill him dead. You understand? Yah has not changed, not one bit. I want you to know, you wicked ones, that the record is written. Hallelujah. Yes, I am a felon. I'm a felon against the wickedness of this damnable wicked world. Hallelujah. I will fight against it. And above all, I will fight against the wickedness in us, the things we do, our corruption. I will fight against that wholeheartedly. I will. Raah goes on to speak Yisrael to his sons of the observing, the observation of what Torah speaks that will avail itself in the achorith, the last days, the achoruth, the days of the end. And when the power of the revelation of this book of life, the revelation of living Torah, shall be revealed. He speaks of this so prophetically, so profoundly, and even poetically in the book of Hanukkah, chapter 108, verse 1. Hallelujah. He speaks about this na'atz, this blasphemy, to despise, to hate, to ridicule, to denounce, to make it despicable, his name, to dung on it. He speaks about this form of blasphemy. There are different forms of blasphemy. He speaks about the na'ats. He says here in the book of Hanukkah, the generation that contemns Yah, they despise him. When a man blasphemes his name, he hates that name. Hanukkah says, Hanukkah 108, verse 1, another book of Hanukkah, which he wrote for his son Methuselah, for those who will come after him. Have we come after Hanukkah? We are of the birth of the lineage of Methuselah and Hanukkah. He says, observing Shema Nasa, to guard, to give one's mind, one's heart to observing the Torah in the Acharon or the Achrit, the last days. And in the last days, we're in the last, the Acharon. We're in the times of the end. No one wants, no preacher tells you to observe the Torah. For those things are antiquated. I had the businessman the other day somewhat tried to inject that. But you don't get by with me with that. You may get by with the weakling, but with me, you don't get by with that. You just don't, I don't allow you to get by with those kinds of statements with me. And I'm not afraid to speak either. My issue out there waiting, I said, I had, well, yeah, open about 20 minutes and I was able to talk. And the folks in line, they were not talking. I was acting just like I am now. And all he could do was listen. And I said, get the book. Bring it here. Let's see what it says. I'm a warrior. And the cause is great. I have no cause. It's his cause. It's his mandate. Yeah, I tell a soldier will fight the fight. But a warrior goes beyond the fight. He goes beyond that. A tough soldier will fight a tough fighter. And of course, they're looking. I was reading the other day that these boys in Iraq and Afghanistan, they're spending to the tune of $5 billion a year just for air conditioning for these boys. That ain't no soldier. We go to the office sometime, many times. Of course, I'm all right. I don't need the fan on. I like for it to get hot in there. I like the sweat. And of course, my friend, Shimri, he'll come in there. You cold? No, I'm not cold, but it's 90 degrees in here, but I don't mind it tempering up a little bit. What's wrong with the fan? Of course, I like to sweat. I like for it to start rolling off of me. I like that. Hallelujah. I like for the sweat to come. It's 90 degrees. It's hot. But of course, you've been outside all day and working in the garden and sweeping. Of course, when you go in there, it feels nice to me. It feels cool. Wow. You got the ceiling fans going. It feels nice. It's cool to me. Real nice. And of course, he will bust that bubble like, man, look, it's hot. Now I want to turn the fan on. Go ahead, man, whatever. To turn it over that way toward you. You don't have to turn it. You turn it that way. Let it blow on you. I'll be all right working around this way, all right? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need to condition our minds that way to hear. When the blast of Yah's fire from his mouth blows upon us, we better be able to stand. We can't be like the chaff. We're going to be consumed. His word is a consuming because he is a consuming fire. And everything that is not of him is coming up, Yisrael. I want to move quickly. He says in verse 2, you who observe the Torah shall wait patiently. Don't we know that the patiently waiting of Yah possess? Know you in your patience, possess ye your nefesh, your life, that you endure without complaining, without murmuring. We are the most hellish murmuring people upon the face of the earth. We murmur about every damn thing, but we never murmur against ourselves and our wickedness. We got to grow up. I never hear children murmur about things and complain. Just give them something, they're all right. They're constantly coming to me because they knew that, they know that Isha, she won't break down. They're, Papi, popsicles? Yeah, tell her. Oh, popsicles, Papi. And of course, she can be somewhat, as she say, no popsicles, no poppies today. Papi, popsicles. So, give them a popsicle. Well, they've already had two already. Well, that's all right. It's a summer thing. Just give them one. It'll be all right. No. Papi. Come on. Give them a popsicle, woman. They'll be all right. Babies are sick. No, a popsicle is not going to make them sick. It's going to make them happy. Even when they're sick, a popsicle will make them happy. Sure will. Give them a popsicle. We like popsicles. We love the sweet things. Talk to me, Yisrael. Hallelujah. You who observe Torah shall wait patiently in all the days until the time of those who work evil is complete. We're going to see the hand of Yah. They're blasphemers. We're going to wait patiently. We're not going to get out of our place. We're not going to remove ourselves from under the covering of Torah, from under the testimony of Yahshua. He said, and the power of the wicked one, Hashatan, shall be brought to Israel. And Shaul talks about that in Thessalonica. As for you, Yisrael, let us wait patiently until sin pass away. For the names of the sinners shall be blotted out from the book of life. And the books, not just a book, but the books of Yah, of Yahweh, the Kadosh or the Kodash one, their seed shall be destroyed forever, and their spirit shall perish and die. Yah says, and they shall cry and lament in a place that is invisible wilderness, and it burns in the fire. In hell, they're going to lift up their eyes. Well, I don't care what those liars, they call themselves Jehovah Witnesses. Yah says they're going to lament in a place that is an invisible fire. An invisible fire. And they shall be there in the wilderness that burns in the fire. For their exit ground, there as upon the earth. He said, I also saw three, there's something like an invisible cloud, just like Yisra'iyah. During the day, the cloud and the pillar of fire at night, invisible, but it was there. But the cloud of Yah, the refreshings of Yah was there before them. And though I could see that it was completely dark, yet I could not see the flame of this fire because it was burning brightly. The fire was so bright. How can we go out in the midst of the day and look on the sun? You see it, but you don't see it. You know you can't look upon that. And that is the brightness of the coming of Yahshua, because everything that is unclean and that has promoted this blasphemy is going to fall dead before him. I want to show you the power of this and what the mind of Yah says. That's why we got to remove that from out of the camp, Yisra'iyah. And there were some like those like bright mountains which form a ring around it, which were tossing it to and fro. Then I asked one of the Kodash Milach, who was with me, saying to him, what is the bright thing? For is not a heaven but merely the flame of a fire which is burning? And a voice of weeping, crying and lamenting, as well as strong pain. And he said to me, this place which you see, it shall be taken, the spirits of sinners and blasphemers, those who do evil, only two, sinners and blasphemers. Hell has enlarged itself without measure. That's why this whore is causing the nations. That's why she has the missionaries. You go down to Jamaica. I don't give a damn what the battle is. You hold fast the truth. Yes. I don't give a damn the opposition. You stand in truth. I don't care how you're tried. Even when weakness before you, you stand to truth. I don't care how you're buffeted and the opposition. You still stand on truth. He said, this place which you see, into it shall be taken the spirits of sinners and blasphemers. There's something vital that we must understand about the blasphemers. And those or na'ats despise and hate. When they hear the name of Yah, they frown and they resist it. Those who do evil, and this is what they do. And those who alter all things which Yah has done through the mouth of the prophets. In this nation here, the oppressor, did they not alter the things that Yah had done through the prophets? Were they not blasphemers? I will say that again. I don't give a damn if you want to protect any kind of people or a mind. Those that oppress, use deceit and blasphemy, did not they alter what the prophets say, that you don't have to keep the commands of Yah? You don't have to do this. You keep Yom Rishon instead of Yom HaShabbat. Did not they do that? Don't you know, like a pack of damn hypocrites? We know that this oppressive spirit of blasphemy has done that. What is done in what we call the Christian whorehouse, every kind of evil. I saw a clip the other day. There's a young man, he has a channel, it is called Ringo, and he is a very polished young man with his videos. So he subscribed to our YouTube, and there are people that I will never meet. They will take the preaching and put it on their website. That's all right. Someone will hear it. I don't care whose it is. It's not his word, his word. It's Yah's mind. That's what it is. So he subscribed. I was surprised that he subscribed to our. I really was. Really was. And there is this clip. It's 1 minute, 26 seconds of this woman. Now I know what $10,000 in $100 bills look like. It's a stack about like that. That's all it is. That's all $10,000 in $100 bill. If it would be that thick, it may be about like that. If you handle money and $10,000 in $100 bill, that's all, that's the thickness like that. That's it. That's all it is. That's all it is. $10,000 in stacks of $100 bills, it would be about that thick. $100 bills, that's all it is. This woman serenades, she looks like a Jezebel. I mean, her pants was tight enough to, you could shoot a rubber band with them. You could shoot a spitball with them. She walks up to this freak, this little freak effeminate man. She hands him a stack of money like that. These were not 20s. In that whole house, there are people that have accessed $100,000. It's nothing to them. And she walks up and hands this freak a stack of bills. No 20s, no ones. You understand? That's why she was grandizing. She did it. She want the world to say. I guarantee you, it was every bit $50,000 to $100,000. She hands him a stack like that. And he tells her, come here, baby girl, and give me a hug. Hell, there are folks that listen will not send one nickel here because this man tells them the truth. But this is what the people love. They strengthen the hands of the evildoers. But a true messenger of Yah, they will not strengthen. Hallelujah. Can I read that one more time? I'm going to close from here. Because I have one, two. I'm going to finish this because this is a promise I will keep. I will show you the mind of Yah. And I speak with the mind of Yah this day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Again, he says, for he says to me, this place which you see into it shall be taken the spirit of sinners and blasphemers, those who do evil, and those who alter the things which Yah has done through the prophets. There's no mindset that has done or altered what the prophets have done, but the mindset, as I utilize, I call it the white mind, like this nation. They have altered the prophets. They have created images that are false and lies, of all which have to be fulfilled. For some of these things were written and sealed above in heaven, so that the Melechim may read them the things that are written and know that which is about to befall or come to pass on sinners, those that defy Torah, and the spirits of the ones who err, who defy the Torah, as well as those that defile their bodies, revenge themselves on Yah and work together with evil people. You cannot work together with the wicked. You cannot strengthen the hands of the evildoers, YHWH. Those, closing with this, those who love Yah, those who have a great love for Yah, those who care for Yah, you know the spirit of blasphemy because they teach the people to love riches and things. Listen to what this say, Quranak. Those who love Yah, they have love neither gold nor silver nor all the tough things which are in the world, what the world calls tough. They have not loved that, but have given over their bodies to endure the suffering of the testimony
of Yahshua HaMashiach. Those who love Yah, or those that don't give a damn, they love the things what the world call excellent, the cars and the things they want, they own. They're so selfish, they don't give a damn. And Yah says, who from the time of their very beginning, the true lineage of YHWH, from the time of their very being, they have not longed after earthly food. They have not desired, they have not wanted the things of the earth. And who regard themselves as mere passing breath. Those that love Yah, they say, I know this ain't nothing. Having food and raiment, I'm contented. Shall fools say, therewith having food and raiment, that will be contented. And so we don't long, those that truly love Yah, they're not worried about the houses that they own or having. If they got someone to lay their head, that's all right. If Shalom lay your head, that's all right. They're not laboring for that. And they have observed this matter. They have heard the mind of Yah speak. Yahweh having put them, and he's going to put us through much testing. Sarah, the fire. Many of the afflictions of the Sadiq. But Yah delivers them out of them all. And put us through much testing. For what reason? That he might receive their pure. They're pure ruach, so that they should hear this in my closing. Out of the pure ruach, so that they should barach his name. That's what it's about. That's what it's about. And the oppressor and the deceiver. When Moshe sought beyond the matter, he sought the power of revelation. What shall be? What is your mind? What shall we do to this one? And that he has given us through must testing, that we shall barach, for we know who our help comes from, and it comes from Yah, that we shall barach his chodash name. And the spirit of oppression and deceit and blasphemy says, don't call on that name. Those under the bondage of oppression, they will say, what name is that you say? Kumbaya. Kumbaya, chopping in the cotton fields and hoeing. Sure they did. Kumbaya, kumbaya. Oh, Masa didn't know what they were singing. Kumbaya, oh, yeah. Kumbaya. And then the one that was being tested, burdened down in the near corners of the cotton field. Oh, yeah. Kumbaya. And you could hear the voice of the plower as the mother hoed. And she was singing, Kumbaya, oh Maya, Kumbaya. And the master would cry, who is the God you're calling on? He's not a God. Kumbaya, Kumbaya. He didn't know she was saying, Kumbaya, Yah. We need you. Our prayer to you, Yah, is come by here. We need you, Yah. We need the mind of Yah and the matters of this hour. And if we don't have his mind, we shall perish. I'm going to continue. I promise next Shabbat, if one of these ark do not preach, I will preach this. May the riches of Yah rest upon you, YHWH. May his strength overcharge you. May the power of his might satisfy your love. May the testimony, the eduth of YHWH cause your heart to delight, you that have joined us on the live broadcast, the live stream. We welcome you all. And be the riches of Yah rest upon you, Ach Simeon, and may his riches rest upon you all. May Yah barak you all. Be strengthened, YHWH. May his shalom shine upon the house of YHWH as we dwell in the city of Yerushalayim, where his shalom is taught. Let us stand to our feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. Send down the rain of the Ruach HaKodesh. In all things we do, barak you, my Abba. We pray for our Achot Blant and our children, our home, to help, to strengthen. We pray for your people
Hear each one, we pray your hand rest upon those and those that are sincerely Yisrayah. We pray for them that have joined us. We pray for our enemies and we brach you for them. In Yahshua's mighty name. Give us shalom this day, rest as we go from this place. Cause our ears to hear and prepare us for the time that is ahead, Yah, and that is only by seeking the mind of Yah in every matter. We ask it all in Yahshua's mighty name. Take us, Achen Shemri, his Ahot, and our Ima down the road safely, and Ahot Jennifer, watch over them all, we ask, in the blessed assurance of the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. 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 Yabrak Yisrael. Shalom.